Hey everyone, Mike here from Pacer. And in this video, we're going to take a look at server management interfaces. We're going to cover the interfaces themselves, what features they have, and also how you can monitor them. Let's get started. So, what are server management interfaces and how can we use them? When we talk about server monitoring, you're probably thinking about monitoring virtual machines, whether they're servers or desktops. But to get a complete picture, it's really important to keep an eye on the base physical hardware, the servers themselves. These days, almost all servers have a management interface that can be used for configuration and firmware upgrades, but also for monitoring the hardware itself. Additionally, they can also offer a remote control option for systems that can be used to configure hardware components, check for errors at the protocol level, and even collect performance statistics. Server management interfaces, or SMIs, can be used at various levels of system architecture, from the hardware level all the way up to the application level. Now, most server manufacturers offer their own SMIs that have been specifically developed for their hardware platforms. Typical functions that can be performed through SMIs include changing system settings, such as fan speed, voltage, and clock frequency. Also monitoring hardware components, such as temperature, disk status, power supply, diagnosing problems, and even managing RAID arrays. With this information, admins can quickly respond to errors and maximize system performance and availability. So, how do you establish a connection to SMIs? To connect to an SMI and check the status of individual components, you're going to need to talk to the server through the remote instance. However, if you've got multiple servers, this process can become really complicated and time-consuming. While other manufacturers offer software solutions that allow multiple servers to be displayed and managed in a single application, these solutions are not always free and usually only include basic monitoring functions. There are several common methods for connecting to an SMI, depending on the type of interface. So, let's have a look at the different types. First, web-based management interfaces. Many SMIs have a web-based management interface that can be accessed through a web browser of your choice. Typically, you'll need to enter the server's IP address or host name to access the management interface, and the login credentials will usually be provided by the server administrator. Second, command line interfaces. Some SMIs also support connection through a command line interface. This typically requires connecting to the server through Telnet or SSH and using commands to control the SMI functions. Next, remote consoles. Some SMIs also support connection through remote consoles. This method usually requires using special software or a driver to connect to the server to access the management interface. And finally, third-party management tools. There are also many third-party management tools that can connect to SMIs. These tools often provide advanced functions and unified user interfaces that can make managing servers and network hardware much easier. So, how do we configure server hardware using SMIs? Even if you have a powerful server system, it can be really difficult to maximize its performance, security, and reliability if you don't have an effective tool for configuring and managing the server itself. This is where the server management interface comes into play. It's a really important part of the IT infrastructure and provides a central interface for configuring servers. Through the SMI, admins can use a variety of configuration options to improve the performance, security, and availability of servers. One of the most important functions of the SMI is the ability to manage the hardware of the system configuration. Admins can configure and manage network interfaces, storage devices, RAID systems, fans, power supplies, and other hardware components to ensure that the server operates smoothly. In addition, the SMI can also help with the management of user accounts and access rights. Admins can create, delete, modify, and disable user accounts as well as set access rights for various resources and services on the server. The SMI can also be used to configure network and security settings, including firewalls, SSL certificates, IP addresses and network masks, and even remote access and VPN. Another important aspect is performance optimization, which is enabled by the SMI. Administrators can optimize performance indicators such as CPU usage, memory consumption, and data throughput to avoid bottlenecks and overloads. The SMI also allows for the configuration of application and services in the server, including databases, web and email servers, backup tools, and other applications and services. In summary, the SMI offers a wide range of configuration options to improve the performance, security, and availability of servers. It's an essential tool for IT administrators to effectively manage and monitor their servers, and it also helps keep the IT infrastructure running smoothly and reliably. So, how can we monitor individual components with SMIs? Today's servers offer a high level of performance and scalability to meet the needs of a large number of users. Therefore, an SMI also provides a range of features that can allow admins to monitor the server status, especially when servers are used as hypervisors and dozens of virtual servers run on them. The smooth operation of the underlying physical server is really important. The failure of a physical server can mean the downtime of a host of virtual servers, and that needs to be prevented at all costs. But with the help of an SMI, you as an admin can monitor various aspects of the server. These can include CPU usage. High CPU usage can cause the server to slow down or become unresponsive. With a server management interface, the CPU usage of the server can be monitored to ensure that it stays within normal range and take measures to reduce it if necessary. Second, memory usage. When storage space runs low, this can also lead to performance issues and system crashes. An SMI can monitor memory usage and issue warnings when storage space is running low, so that the admin can take action to free up or expand the storage spaces if needed. Thirdly, network traffic. An SMI can monitor incoming and outgoing network traffic to ensure that the server isn't overloaded and to detect possible attacks or security breaches. Next, server logs. Logs can contain important information such as error messages, warnings, and user activities. An SMI can automatically search the logs and issue warnings when unusual activities or error messages occur. And finally, hardware status. A server consists of many other components, including fans, power supplies, and memory. An SMI can monitor the status of these hardware components to ensure that they're all functioning properly. And perhaps the biggest disadvantage of server monitoring through SMIs is that each server communicates individually through its own interface. If the servers are all using hardware from different manufacturers, the challenge of getting a centralized overview and identifying problems becomes even greater. So, what's the solution? Centralized monitoring software. If you have multiple SMIs that you want to monitor in one place, there are several options available to you. Firstly, server manufacturers often provide an application that allows you to manage all interfaces in one place. But unfortunately, these applications are usually not available for free. Secondly, you can use centralized monitoring software that's capable of monitoring multiple SMIs simultaneously and storing the data in one place. These applications enable the monitoring of multiple servers and can offer much more than just notifying you when problems occur. They can provide more comprehensive monitoring and analysis of data to detect potential issues before they lead to major outages. Furthermore, such applications offer comprehensive monitoring functionality, including monitoring of network devices, operating systems, applications, and services. Network traffic and bandwidth usage can also be monitored to optimize network performance. Pesla PRTG fulfills all of these requirements and many more. Our product is a powerful network monitoring software with comprehensive monitoring features, including monitoring of network devices, servers, applications and services, as well as network traffic and bandwidth usage. It's easy to set up and configure and provides automated alerts via various channels. PRTG is scalable and customizable to the specific requirements of your company, offers a fair price performance ratio, and is suitable for networks of different sizes and complexities. So that's the spiel over and done with. If you like what you heard and would like to know more, head over to our website and give PRTG a go for yourself. The link is in the description. And if you like this video, please just give us a like and subscribe and maybe drop a comment in below. Thanks for watching. See you next time.